Well, this is the top story at this hour. His commander Burhan Wani's encounter has triggered protests in South Kashmir. Protesters blocked the national highway between Jammu and Srinagar. In Srinagar, some protesters even attacked the India Today TV crew and broke their cameras. Authorities have imposed curfew and restricted the movement of people. Internet services have been shut down in South Kashmir. Hurriyat Chief Saeed Ali Shah Gilani has called for Kashmir Band. Joining his call for Kashmir Band is Asia Andrabi, who has asked the shops to be closed for 3 days as a precautionary measure. Many Hurriyat leaders, including Gilani, Mirwais and Yasin Malik, have been put under house arrest in Srinagar.
As far as Burhan Wani is concerned, he was the poster boy of militancy to a certain degree. He used to keep making his videos and keep releasing them from time to time. A lot of people used to view it over here. Courtesy which he had a bit of acceptance in the valley. As far as this operation is concerned, it was a joint operation between RR, 19 National Rifles, SOG and CRPF, and it was a successful operation and a very clean operation in which no collateral damage was done and a lot of recoveries had been done from these people.
So here's how our security forces carried out the crucial operation to neutralize Burhan Wani. 19th Battalion of RR and JNK SOG launched the joint operation. Burhan Wani was holed up with two armed terrorists, and it was a specialized unit of forces that moved from Srinagar. It was a top secret operation. The information was kept closely guarded. The security forces followed the drill and laid a cordon, a perimeter, around Burhan Wani's location. The army and police teams laid cordon. In afternoon, terrorists also opened fire on security forces, but the security forces were undeterred. Additional forces were called in. Troops succeeded in eliminating Burhan Wani and three terrorists. So terrorist commander and Hizbul poster boy Burhan Wani was today killed in an encounter yesterday with the security forces in Anantnag. Undoubtedly, it is a huge blow for the terror organization in the valley. Burhan led the latest crop of tech-savvy local terrorists who use social media to influence and recruit the Kashmiri youth.
Young, brash and in your face, Burhan Wani has finally been eliminated. The Hizbul Mujahideen terrorist, who became a viral phenomenon this year for his use of social media to propagate jihad, posing for photographs with his terror comrades and cocking a snook at the government. 21-year-old Burhan Muzaffar Wani became an online icon for terror groups operating in the Kashmir Valley and has been the most hunted man for security forces for over 10 months. He shot to fame as being the centerpiece of this photograph. And with his death, every terrorist in this picture is dead. 6 years ago, when he was 15, Wani left home to take up arms against the Indian state. Since then, the government has announced a 10 lakh rupees bounty on his head and taken out most of his close associates. But Wani survived, defying all expectations and leaving a trail of stories behind him. On the 13th of April last year, security forces had gunned down his brother Khalid Wani in an encounter in Tral. A smooth talker, clad in Western fatigues, he addresses the valley's youth through a series of video clips that all went viral, shared rapidly on WhatsApp and other services. The young terrorist made full use of social media to reach out to youth, recruit fighters, and create an aura of brazenness around his operations. Recently, these images of Burhan Wani playing cricket went viral, forcing security forces to wonder about the impunity and fearlessness with which Burhan's brigade had been operating. The brain behind several terror strikes and operations, Burhan Wani has finally been hunted down. With Shujaul Haq in Srinagar, Bureau Report, India Today.
Well, 21-year-old Burhan Wani was poster boy for the terrorist organization. He had started reaching out to youth through social media. Gaurav Sawant breaks down Burhan Wani's neutralization, how our security forces worked and the significance for terror groups in the valley with this dire warning of security forces which are acting against terrorists.
This was the face of new terror in Jammu and Kashmir. Terrorists who did not hide their faces. This is Burhan Wani, Islam Shah, Wasim Khan, all these terrorists of the Hizbul Mujahideen, Tariq Pandit, as you see in these pictures, and this is what has happened. These terrorists were not scared to show their faces. They showed their weapons. They gave up jobs. They gave up education. They became terrorists. This was called the rise of terrorism once again. But this is what happens to anyone who picks up the gun against the Indian Armed Forces in Jammu and Kashmir. Burhan Wani is now dead in Kokarnan. The 19th Battalion of the Rashtriya Rifles and the Special Operations Group of the Jammu and Kashmir Police, they carried out a joint operation based on very specific intelligence. Burhan Wani had stopped using his mobile phone because he knew his phones were tapped. He was only communicating with people. But what he didn't realize was the fact that people in South Kashmir were actually giving information to the police, to the CRPF and to the army about terrorist movement. And very recently, he warned people in Jammu and Kashmir. Just before Eid, a video of Burhan Wani came out where he warned people, anyone giving information to the police or the army will be shot dead. Burhan Wani, the face of terror in Jammu and Kashmir, is dead himself, as are 9 of these 11 faces.